sacrifice animals, seeking to draw nearer to Allah Azza wa Jalla. The pilgrims will find the project of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for utilizing the meat from sacrificed animals an excellent assistance to them for the performing of their nusuk, takbirat. It is observed during the stoning of Jamrat that some pilgrims commit certain errors. We will mention some of them. The belief of some pilgrims that they are throwing a stone at the shaitan. So they throw with great fury and anger accompanied with insults and cursing of the shaitan. When in reality, the throwing of stones at the Jamrat was not prescribed except as an establishment of dhikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Belting the Jamrat with large stones or even with shoes or pieces of wood, this is exceeding the proper bounds as an exaggeration in the religion, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade us from. Crowding, competing, and fighting amongst each other in order to build the Jamrat is a huge error. It is obligatory upon the pilgrim that he shows friendliness and gentleness to his fellow Muslims and to take care in throwing into the correct place, which is inside the basin, regardless of whether the pillars are struck or not. Throwing the stones all together in a single stroke, in which case it would not be considered except as a single stone. The correct and legitimate way is to throw one stone after another and to recite Allahu Akbar with each stone. Once the pilgrim has built the Jamrat al-Aqaba and has shaved or shortened his hair, then the first releasing from the state of Ihram is complete for him. He can therefore wear his normal clothes again. Everything which was made forbidden for pilgrims due to the Ihram becomes allowed except for intimate contact with their spouses. Tawaf al-Ifada. Next, the pilgrim moves to Mecca in order to perform the Tawaf al-Ifada. This is the main pillar, so the Hajj is not complete without performing it. He must also perform the Sa'i after it if he is making Hajj al-Tamattu'. As for the ones performing the Hajj of Qiran or Ifrad, then they must perform Sa'i only if they did not do it previously with their Tawaf al-Qudum. Once the pilgrim has completed the Tawaf al-Ifada on the day of sacrifice, everything which was made prohibited by the Ihram becomes allowed again, including intimate contact with their spouses. The days of Tashriq. Next, the pilgrim returns to Mina to stay there for 3 days of Tashriq, which constitute the nights of the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th. Or, if one wishes to leave early, he may remain only for 2 nights. In confirmation, the pilgrim must build the 3 Jamrat after the sun has passed its meridian, on the days that are spent in Mina, and he should say Allahu Akbar with each stone that is thrown. It is from the Sunnah, after having built the small Jamrat, and then again after the middle Jamrah, to stand facing the Qibla with raised hands and to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever one wishes. As for the Jamrah closest to Mecca, which is Jamrat al-Aqaba, then one does not stand nor supplicate after building it. For he who intends to stay only for 2 days, he must build the 3 Jamrat on the 12th day. After the sun passes its meridian, then he must leave Mina before the sun sets. For if the sun sets and he has not begun his journey to leave, there must he remain and spend the night of the 13th and build the Jamrat on the 13th day. The farewell Tawaf. The journey takes us back to the noble city of Mecca. One more time for the performance of the Tawaf around the ancient house, bringing the whole journey close to its completion. After the pilgrim has completed the performance of their Ansak with all their pillars and obligations, then they should make their final act, the farewell Tawaf, around the secret house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in compliance with the order of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which was reported to have said, none of you should depart until he has made his final act at the house of Allah. So the farewell Tawaf is the final obligation of the Hajj, which the pilgrim must perform immediately before his direct return journey to his home country. No one is excused from the farewell Tawaf except the woman in menstruation or those in the post-childbirth condition. The Prophet's city, the manner of visiting the Prophet's mosque. the place toward which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated and where he was finally buried. We prepare for the journey of visiting the Prophet's mosque, which is one of the three mosques besides which it is not allowed to make a specific journey towards. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reported to have said, don't prepare for a specific journey towards any mosque except the three, which are the sacred mosque in Mecca, my mosque, and Masjid al-Aqsa. Visiting the Prophet's mosque is not a condition nor an obligation for Hajj. In fact, it has no connection or any relation to Hajj, and there is no state of ihram for it. However, visiting it is prescribed and recommended at any time throughout the year, being as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it possible and facilitated one's arrival at the land of the two holy sanctuaries. It would be highly recommended to travel to the city of the Prophet to perform Salah in the Prophet's mosque, in which a single Salah is counted as being more superior than 1,000 Salah performed in any other mosque except the Masjid al-Haram in Mecca, in which one Salah is superior to 100,000. Also, the person should give salutations to the messengers of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Dear visitor, when you arrive at the Prophet's mosque, proceed with your right foot on entering and say, I seek refuge with Allah the Supreme and His noble face and His everlasting authority from the accused devil. O Allah, open the doors of your mercy for me. This supplication is prescribed to be recited on entering all mosques. After entering the mosque, hasten to perform the two rak'ah of Salah, known as Tahiyyat Masjid. And how excellent it would be if this Salah could be performed in a rawdah. But if that is not possible, then perform the Salah at any place in the mosque. Next, go to the grave of the Prophet and stand in front and facing it. You should begin with salutation upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in a sensible manner and in a low voice, saying, peace be upon you, Prophet, and also the mercy of Allah and His blessings. Then you move a short distance to your right so that you stand in front of the grave of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Then you give him your salutations as you did to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Once again, you move a short distance on your right until you are standing in front of the grave of Umar. Then you give him your salutations as you did to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is noticed that some visitors to the Prophet's mosque commit certain errors which are regarded as being innovations, all of which have no basis in the Sharia and are not reported from the actions of the companions of the Prophet. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased with them all. Amongst the errors are the following: wiping one's hand against the netting or grill of the Prophet's room and walls of the mosque, facing the grave while supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the correct way is to face the direction of the Qibla. After that, it's also recommended for you to visit the graves of those buried in Al-Biqa', in which are gathered the graves of a large number of the companions, amongst which is that of the third Khalifa, Uthman ibn Affan. May Allah be pleased with him. Likewise, one should visit the graves of the martyrs of the Battle of Uhud, which includes the grave of the leader of martyrs, Hamza bin Abd al-Muttalib. You should greet them.
كما يسن لك أخي الزائر ما دمت في المدينة أن تذهب متطهرا إلى مسجد قباء.
It's also recommended that while you are in Medina that you travel to Masjid Qubba in a state of purity, which was the first mosque to be built in Islamic history. So you visited and performed Salah inside it, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did, and often encouraged others to do so. There are no other mosques or places beside these mentions that are prescribed for you to visit in Medina. So a person should not inconvenience himself and take on traveling here and there to places for which there is no reward in visiting. It is most fitting upon the pilgrimage of Hajj or Umrah.